Okay, welcome back. Today we have something a little bit special for you. You're going to get some insight into our laser coaching sessions where Kate and I coach students personally. Now, of course, our CCA students always have access to our coaching calls twice a month, and then, of course, our fabulous Facebook group as well. But these are special calls where we really get to dig into their specific questions in that moment. They're only 10 minutes, but boy, do we pack a lot of coaching and information in there. The topics are going to run the gamut. So no matter what you are interested in as a copywriter, even though you're not in the hot seat, I guarantee that you're going to hear something useful and interesting. Also, just a heads up that in a couple of the recordings, students mention Pitchapalooza and Right Starts, which are a couple of our student-only events. They're free for our students. And as with everything we do, they're designed to get people taking action and seeing success. So when you hear that reference, just know that that's what they are. So without further ado, let's dig into our laser coaching sessions. Okay, so we've got 10 minutes. What can we help you with?
Awesome. Awesome. Let's go. So I just like put my little like little
yes.
kind of pointers awesome. Thing that I wanted to. So basically, I guess I just like today, I wrote my 15th kind of pitch, right? So the pitching palooza really helped me. So yay. So I guess what would be your recommendation for my next steps? What I'm finding is, I mean, I'm a extrovert, so it's like it's not hard for me to do, but I just like I haven't been, I guess maybe I don't know how successful I thought, and I mean, like, success is a very, you know, whatever, like, you know, different to everybody. But so I do feel like I've had a lot of wins so much in the last like 6 months, but I'm just like, what do you think my next step should be? Because I feel like I'm pulled in all like, you know, a lot of different directions. And I just like, since I'm trying to laser focus, I'm like, what do you think as a kind of a newbie to this particular career field? Yes. You know, I've been, you know, teacher and pharmacist, and you know, I'm a mom, a wife, you know, so I have like I'm a small group leader at my church, and so I have a lot of like talent and service to provide. Mm-hmm. I just don't know as far as breaking into this particular, what are your guys' recommendations? Well, am I like, is it like a pipe trip? Well, I know you're, you know, you guys were trying to encourage and stuff like that, but I feel like I just want to be mentored, and you guys are doing a great job of that, but I just want to know, like, what should I now like do? Like, just, is it just keep pitching, or what do y'all think? Should I start applying for like part-time remote agency jobs just to get more experience? I don't know. Like, I'm kind of like, I don't exactly know what I should do next.
Mm-hmm. So the great news is that we know what you, or at least I could guess at what your goal is, right? Is more consistent income, right? From copywriting. Awesome.
Yeah. And to gain more experience and exactly. to get more clients. Yeah. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. So the good news is there's a very specific next step. And that is to get your pitching to a place where you're consistently sending out pitches every single week. Now, if you want to mix in, if you see an agency position, or if you see something you think, oh, I'd be kind of interested in that, then absolutely apply for that. Apply for it the same way that you would pitch, right? So do the research and send it out to the hiring manager, who you think would be the hiring manager, not the, you know, not just the general application mailbox, but at the steps you are, a lot of students want to overcomplicate it. They want to go, all right, well, should I, then I should be posting on social media, and maybe I should be, and all that stuff is great, but supplemental to pitching, because pitching is the absolute best way and the only proven way to control your own opportunities, right? Because the more pitches you send out, and nobody's going to say yes to every pitch, right? But the more pitches you send out, the more people you will get who will say yes. You'll get plenty that say no, and you'll get plenty that don't get back to you. But pitching consistently, and also adding in following ups, which if you haven't yet, now's the time to add in follow ups to go with your pitching. But that is what you need to focus on, and in order to get to those goals. Don't let, like you were saying, they're pulled in a lot of different ways. Don't let yourself get pulled. Don't let yourself get distracted by, oh, well, I'm posting on LinkedIn and I'm posting on this and this. Absolutely. And when you've sent your pitches for the week, then absolutely go post on Instagram and post on, but that is, those are kind of dotted lines to maybe landing clients. A direct line to landing clients is pitching.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cause I have tried a couple of the follow-up things. I guess I struggle with like knowing what the value that, you know, so like Amy had told me about, like, I did try one of her tone guide things to a recording music studio that I pitched, but I mean, I don't know. I didn't get the email returned. I've done some of the other stuff where you can test if your email is spammy or whatever. It seems like my flags are okay on that. So I don't know if they're just like too busy, they're not, or if it goes to their spam and I just don't know. You know, I
don't think about it because it's not in your control.
So yeah, control what's in your business. But I'm just like, so what, you know, I guess I just, so I have like my list of like, you know, and I keep adding because mm-hmm. like it adds, I have like, you know, 78 on my pitch list now. And like today something came into my inbox and I remember my daughter, she likes this particular clothing brand and I like their mission that they have behind that. So I seem mm-hmm. to like tend to like enjoy pitching and like, you know what I mean? Potentially working for things that either I've tried or missions that I like mm-hmm. or
great.
Yeah. So mm-hmm. that seems to be what I'm drawn for. Cause a lot of people are like, oh, why don't you just write for, you know, medical? And I'm like, cause I don't really, that's not, to me, that's like kind of like boring. And I'm like, and I don't really want to be a technical writer. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I've gotten asked to like write grants, you know, because I'm mm-hmm. involved in my church. I'm like, well, that's not really what a coffee ring, you know what I mean?
And
a lot of people are like, oh, well, you just said, you know, they don't understand what a copywriter is. So it's like,
people
explaining that.
People are going to have all kinds of suggestions. People are going to have all kinds of ideas, but they're also often going to be people who aren't in the copywriting industry, The sending out pitches and then sending out your first follow-up a week later, and then your second follow-up a week after that, if you haven't heard from them, is absolutely what you want to do with every single follow-up. And your ideas for the follow-up, definitely go back and watch that. I think it's fourth week of Pitchapalooza, Kate, when we talk about follow-ups. Because mm-hmm. you want the resources you should be sending out should be like podcast episodes or articles or things that you've come across that are useful, so that it's very simple. Do not overcomplicate sending the follow-ups either. And check out the client pitching masterclass as well, because we go through follow-ups in there. But that should be the simplest part of all of this. But you send out the follow-ups because people's inboxes are so busy, all of that kind of thing. How many pitches would you say that you are sending on average a week right now?
Because I'm part-time, like I do this part-time. So like, I just do like I try to do like one a day. And some days if I can do like, you know what I mean? That's kind of like what I've been doing, but yeah, I need to, I guess, go back to that follow-up and like, is it okay? Like, even if you haven't followed up and it's been a while, cause I started really pitching hard when we were going through the Pitchapalooza, is it okay to just like, you know,
absolutely.
And then just, yeah. So that was a question. Mm-hmm. My other frustration, and quick question, do part-time remote agency jobs, do those even exist, or is that like a
part-time? Yep.
Yes.
I work freelance with an agency. It's not, technically not part-time, I guess, but in the sense of freelancing, which is mm-hmm. part-time, I guess, depending how you want to classify part-time.
Okay. So cause I'm just like, maybe I need to just like start checking like that, those keyword, like part-time remote, you know, or part-time freelance or whatever, something like that. You know what I mean?
Or just look at, you know, to your point, if there are companies that you're drawn to, or look at agencies in your area, look at their clients that they serve on their website. And if there's somewhere you're like, ooh, I like these companies that they're working with, this feels like this aligns with me, pitch that agency. You can also do it that way too. So obviously look at what agencies are putting out there in the world, if they're job postings, but also know you don't have to wait for a job posting to pitch them, because I can tell you from experience from many agencies I've worked with that they all need copyright. There's enough turnover. There's enough work coming in sometimes that they need an extra copywriter. So definitely look your area beyond your area and see if, okay, this, you know, here's some brands/organizations that I'm drawn to and add those to your pitch list. Yeah, certainly. Okay.
Another like just little frustration that I've been having is like, I'll see like work, but like, and it'll be like part copywriting, but a lot of it's like graphic design. It's like, mm-hmm. so do I just, should I just, and I do have like my friend, she's a realtor, but she's also a graphic designer. So that's kind of like, I've worked with her and I've worked with a couple other kids that I've just reached out on.
There will be a lot of listings you see where people are trying to cram in as much as possible. They want someone who will do everything.
They're finding a unicorn. Yeah,
exactly. Whether or not they're actually able to find that person is a different story. So absolutely apply to them, but definitely don't rely on the jobs that are being posted out there, because there's so much more opportunities out there than jobs that are being posted. You know, there are plenty of projects that companies need help with that they don't post on, you know, for job listings and that kind of thing. So definitely apply for everything you see. Why not? But don't limit yourself to just the things that you're seeing. Does that make sense? Yeah.
And for some of the pitches that I have done, like I've just kind of tried to like vary them up to just to see, oh, mm-hmm. what do yeah. I get bites with? And so yeah. I have said like, hey, you know, I like your website. Like I don't have anything mm-hmm. like to offer because I think their website, you know, everything looks good, like from what I can see. So I'll just be like, you know, hey, like, I really love your mission. I love, you know, compliment.
You still need to include an idea though. Go back and check at which maybe week two we talk about it, because you do need to provide, because you're showing them that you have, that you think strategically, even if it's the idea that gets your foot in the door. It doesn't necessarily have to be the idea that they're going to hire you for, but you do need to show that what you do provides value for them. So you do need to have that idea in your pitch emails. Yeah.
So as I don't know if this is an off the top of the head example, so bear with me, but say for example, you see a company you want to pitch, you haven't subscribed to their emails, everything's feeling good, social looks good, all of that. Maybe one of their competitors though, you get an email from them that's mm-hmm. like about something specific and you can pitch to this, hey, I saw this email and it was focused on this. Have you tried doing something like this before?
Mm-hmm. And it would benefit you in this way.
Exactly. And here's what that could do and blah, 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 blah. Their answer might be like, yeah, we've done that. But I think what the point is that it shows that you're thinking, you're looking at competitors, you're thinking about their brand, you're looking for ways to add value. And that's really the crux of it. It might be an idea, like I said, that they've already done, or, but it also might not be. Maybe they're like, oh yeah, that is something we should do. But to Nikki's point, it's to get your foot in that door to say, oh yeah, we want to work with her because she's thinking in the way that we want to work with someone who thinks mm-hmm. like that, not someone gotcha. Who's, you know, looking for us to just hand them projects. You're a partner. They want that partner. And yeah, that's demonstrating.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. And I went back and I'm working, even though I've finished all the original foundation, whatever, but now I'm almost done with the new ones that y'all put out in January for the new action sheets.
Mm-hmm. So now yes. Mm-hmm. Awesome.
Yeah. So I do appreciate the new stuff, because like for us that don't have a lot of clients yet, you know what I mean? It for me, it gives me that, like the carrot in front of the, you know what I mean? Like it motivates me to keep as well, do the things that you can win, like these little sessions. Like for me, like that's like, I don't know. That's my encouragement. Like, and I enjoy like giving the feedback like to my peers, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? Because it's, and I really think you guys have done an amazing job. Just how, I mean, you guys are hilarious. I like watching all your Instagram posts. I'm like, oh my God. Like, and I can tell when you do them, Kate, and versus like, I mean, you guys have your different little styles, but it just cracks me up. I'm like, oh, there they go again. Like, so from a consumer, it's very, you know, it obviously works well. You're very successful. So like, but I like, compared to some of the other copyright, you know what I mean? That mm-hmm. you kind of see out there and you're just like, okay, I do appreciate the authenticity and the genuine like heart that you have for actually like helping people be the best. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's not just
thank you.
And like, Kate, how you're like, you guys have access to this for life. So it's not like, and honestly, like when I decided, I'm like, well, that is true.
So well, and Krista, I'm so sorry to stop you, but we have our next person in the room. But thank you. I hope this was helpful. Will you share in the group the pitches and the following up that you're sending?
I was going to say, keep sharing pitches in the group.
I'll share.
Awesome.
Let us know.
Yeah.
All right. Bye. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Like what you heard? Hit subscribe so you never miss a video. And if you're ready to take the first step toward becoming a copywriter yourself, sign up for a free video training right here.